Computing is changing every facet of life. This fact could not be more true than here on campus at Duke University. We have launched a new course called First Year Computing, a course that's focused on training our students around how to think about computational problems and how to decompose these problems into fundamental steps, as opposed to just focusing on programming syntax. I am Dean Jerry Lynch, the Vinnick Dean of Engineering, and I'll be introducing to you today Professor Genevieve Lipp, the director of our first year computing course. Hey, Genevieve.
Hi.
Genevieve, thank you so much for taking the time to share with us the exciting things you're doing in first year computing. Can we begin by having you describe what is first year computing?
Certainly. Thank you for asking. First Year Computing is our new program that teaches first year students in all the majors in Pratt how to use computing as a tool to solve engineering problems and how to do that collaboratively. The original idea was that computational thinking was a more important skill than learning specific computational methods, so it replaces the old computational methods course.
Can you describe the framework that you use to teach students computational thinking?
We use a framework called the 7 steps, developed by my colleague Andrew Hilton in ECE. And the basic idea is that we break down devising an algorithm into introspecting how you as a human do it. And we do that step by step. It's the first 4 steps. And then there's a step that's translation to code, of course, and then testing and debugging, which we also emphasize more than I think a lot of programming courses do.
What are the learning objectives that you have for the students? Like, what would computing fluency look like?
I want students to understand how computing is used as a tool in engineering and then be able to use that to solve any engineering problem they set their mind to. For me, the heart of computational thinking is observing how you as a human solve a problem and look for opportunities for a computer to help, and then formulate the problem in a way that it can be computed on.
It sounds like the course really is focusing more on programming abstractions than on programming languages, which is unique.
I think so. I think that's the most important skill, and I think it's going to future-proof this education for students. The languages they need to use will probably change. They probably won't all be using Python 10 years from now, and that's okay. They might be asking a large language model or LLM to do it. They might be prompting. But the skill of learning to think in abstractions, break down a problem into its pieces, and express it really specifically will be relevant far into the future. That helps you even if you're nowhere near a computer.
One of the secrets of the course is deriving problems from the real world. Can you describe how that works and how that's actually helping students learn computing with this context of the real world?
I think it is really important to have context when you're working on a problem. And I also think it's a lot more motivating to learn engineering skills in context. So we have scoped problems that have real world roots, such as modeling the deorbit of the ISS or using data from a sleep study to diagnose a patient, but we don't have clients. And I made that choice deliberately because having a client adds a layer of pressure onto students, and students sometimes are already kind of anxious about learning to program. So I decided to scope the problems so that we don't deliver anything to a client at the end, but they are inspired by things that a real engineer would do.
You're teaching your second cohort of first year computing this year. Can you describe some of the successes you've seen as an instructor already by year 2 of this course?
The most successful mark of last semester's cohort were definitely the student projects. For example, one of the projects was modeling the deorbit of the International Space Station, and some groups of students did their numerical simulation and plotted it, but then some went above and beyond and actually animated these simulations so that you could see how the system was evolving with time. And that is not something I told them to do. It's not something I taught them how to do, but that was really a mark that they had that self-efficacy to get an idea of something they wanted to do in computing and learn how to do it on their own.
Is there any aspect of the course that you're most proud of?
The thing I'm most proud of is the high level of quality the student projects wind up with. But the thing I'm most proud of that I had a hand in is our grading framework. It's important to me that the students develop resilience throughout the course, and I want to give them the opportunity to do that without worrying about their grades so much. Like, if you didn't pass the quiz this first time, that's okay. There's another version with a fresh problem that you can attempt again in 2 weeks. Computing is such a fundamental skill. It's not okay to get 70% of the way there on a fundamental skill. So I want to give students multiple chances to reach it so that by the end of the course, everyone who passes the course is really ready to go.
Given that we're still in only our second year of offering first year computing, what do you see as the opportunities for innovation? Like, what more are you looking to implement in the course? And what kind of experiences are you trying to provide the students?
I want the menu of projects we offer to keep evolving. I want to stay current with students' interests. I try to survey them every semester, what are you interested in, and try to create projects that are meaningful to students. And I'd also like to enhance the industry involvement and the technical mentorship that people who aren't instructors in the course bring to the projects. You want it to represent something you could be doing in your engineering practice.
Genevieve, thank you so much for sharing with us all the innovation you have ongoing in first year computing. We are so excited to see the course evolve. Thank you so much. Appreciate it. Thank you. What is your favorite movie or movie scene that ties to computing?
I actually use a movie scene in our first class session when I'm trying to motivate students and show them what's possible with computing. And it's from Hidden Figures. When Katherine Johnson, who was a NASA scientist, is explaining to all of her colleagues, we don't need exact solutions for the path of the shuttle because we can go old school and use Euler's method to numerically simulate it.
That's the power of computing.
Yes.
I love it, and I love that movie.